I'm going to show you some basic creating on the Vita. So to start off, I'm going to show you touch create. So you have two options right here on the side. This will open up your pop-it, and then this will bring up like a quick menu on the side, which is pretty much the same thing. So we're going to go to our materials, bring up cardboard, and by the way, you can use this button right here to make large pop-it. So I'm going to select my object. First, I want to show you right up here, you can change it between static and dynamic, just like on the PSP. Dynamic is the material has its basic properties, and then if you go here to static, it acts as if it's dark matter and it can't move, but it still has its normal looks. So we have this option right here on the left where you have your a stamp, paintbrush, eraser, and a hole punch. So right here I have paintbrush activated, so I can paint with my finger just like that, and then the stamp, it's you can only touch, you can't drag, it's only stamp. And then you can resize with two fingers, and you can also rotate. You could always use the traditional controls of the analog sticks, but you can't use the stamp tool because you just click. So that's pretty much your stamp tool. Now, the eraser, the same thing. Pull the eraser, triangle, or you can erase, or you can paint erase. You can also use the hole punch, which is just like the stamp, but it erases. You can also select objects by just touching the screen and pulling your pop-it, and then that's how you can select objects. You don't have to go to your pop-it down here and then select the pop-it cursor. So pick that up, just tap it, and then you have it selected already. And then you can go to the click on the wrench, and then it has all its settings right there. When you select one, you can copy it, which is this one over here. And you can also go over here and flip it. You have the options of horizontally flipping it or vertically flipping it. So I'm going to flip it vertically like that, or horizontally. It looks the same because I'm using square, but you get the point. You can also hide objects just like you could in LBP 2. What you do is you just tap the L button and you can reveal what's behind it. And if you want to bring it back, you hold down the L button and it's back to normal. Changing layers on the Vita is awesome. You can select it, and then you hold down the L button, and it brings up a layers menu. You can tap where you want to change the layers to go to, or you can drag them. Or you can just use the left stick and the right stick. In the Vita, a new feature is you can combine the thin layer and the thick layer together. So as you see here, I have the thick layer, and then I also have two thin layers in the front and back. Let me show you. So I can take those thin layers off. Oops. And if you look closely, you can see that the left one is slightly thicker, because I have the thin layers in the front and the back. And you can do that for every layer. You can use the back control for zooming in and zooming out. It's extremely useful when you are holding something and you need to zoom out and then move it. You can also use one finger to slide the screen back and forth. It's two fingers to zoom in and out. You can also use the rear touch zooming when you're in your poppet with your costume. You can also do this while you are placing a sticker. I don't know why the camera is off to the left like that, or off to the right. It must be a bug or something, but you can move the camera around. So that is a basic creating. Thanks for watching.